Museum in London to meet head curator Terry Charman and look at an extremely rare document in their collection. It's now infamously known as the Black Book.
Well, it contains nearly 3,000 names of personalities that were going to be taken into protective custody by the Nazis had the invasion of Britain, Operation Sea Lion, proved successful. But it also, of course, includes a lot of British personalities like Churchill, Anthony Eden, Duff Cooper, the most prominent three anti-appeasers, plus Neville Chamberlain, the appeaser himself, plus some very strange personalities to find in an arrest list like this.
Can we have a look at some of the bigger names you're talking about? I think it's
Winston Spencer, Minister President, and he was really found at Westrum Kent, Chartwell Manor.
Noel Coward, why is he on the list?
Well, Noel Coward, I think, is on the list because during the period of the Phoney War, the first 9 months of the war, Coward was working with the French, liaison with the French on propaganda exercise in Paris. And I think that obviously this was picked up on, that he was all swaggering down the Rue de Rivoli wearing a naval uniform, that was one claim. The writer, Nancy Cunard, whose mother, Lady Cunard, actually was one of von Ribbentrop's favourite hostesses when he was ambassador in London, ironically. She's on the list there.
Although we have some quite famous names, we've also got some quite obscure ones, men just described as businessmen in Riga. Who are these people?
Well, in November 1939, there was the famous or infamous incident of the Venlo, where the Nazis kidnapped two British secret agents quite high up. And it is assumed that in their interrogations, some of these names slipped out.
And these are names of
people that were in the British Secret Service, MI6.
MI6 agents. Yes. So actually, there are some very, very important names the Nazis did. They're not just politicians or sort of leading figures in society. They're actually intelligence officers as well.
Yes, their subsequent fate was measured by what happened to the sort of people similar to them in occupied Poland, because there was a listing that the Nazis had made of Polish personalities that were marked for, well, death, basically.
So all 3,000 or so people in this book would have ended up in concentration camps, and then you think almost certainly would have been killed?
Yes, yes.
Americans living in Britain are not immune to this Nazi brutality. The great singer and actor Paul Robeson is marked as an African-American with strong communist affiliations. Robeson has in fact already returned to America, but all those of Hitler's so-called inferior races will become targets.
It's very easy to surmise from what we know about the history of Nazi Germany and Hitler's aims and plans and policies, that he would have rounded up and deported the Jews and others that he didn't like the look of, that he would have also exterminated the asylum population. So he murdered the mentally and physically handicapped in Germany. And there's no reason why he wouldn't have done the same in any of the places that he took over.